Vanakkam and welcome to our YouTube channel Success Editive. In this video, we are going to learn about the most important topic of all the competitive examinations, simplification. Let's get started. So, what is simplification and what are we going to see about in this topic? The most important rule in the simplification is the Bodmer's rule. So, what is Bodmer's rule? Let's take an example. Let's just say I give you an expression 100 minus 50 divided by 2. What is the value of this expression? There is a minus operation and a division operation. There will be two possibilities. Depends on which operation you do it first. The first one is, if you subtract it first, you get 100 minus 50, 50, and then divide by 2, you will get 25 as the answer. But if you divide it first, you get 100 minus divide 50 divided by 2 minus 25, and then subtract, you will get 75. So there are two different possibilities, depends on which operation you do first. So what is the right answer? Is it 25 or 75? Which operation should be done first? Is it division or subtraction? This is where the Bodmer's rule came to help us. The full form of Bodmer's is bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Whatever the expression is, whatever how long the expression is, you have to calculate in this order. You have to do the bracket first and then off. Off is just a useful multiplication, and then divide, multiply, addition and subtraction. It is the order of the operation. All our calculators and computers follow this Bodmer's rule. Right? So look at this. The division is the first compared to the subtraction. So you have to do the division first and then do the subtraction. So if you divide 50 by 2, you get 25, and 100 minus 25 is 75. So 75 is the right answer, 25 is not. So this is Bodmer's rule. Not only the simplification topic, in all of the topics we are going to follow this rule. Okay. Now let's take another example. So here's another example. So what they given is 5005 minus 5000 divided by 10. So see the Bodmer's rule. You have to do the division first. So 5000 divided by 10 is 500, and then do the subtraction. 5005 minus 500 is equal to 4505. So your final answer is 4505. Let's take another example. Here's another question. 7500 plus 1250 divided by 50. What is the value of this expression? See the Bodmer's rule. You have to do the operation in the bracket first. So this is the bracket, and you got 1250 divided by 50. So what will you get if you divide 1250 divided by 50? The 0 will get cancelled, and you divide by 5, you get 25. So the value of this expression is 25, and then add it to the 7500. So you will get 7525 as the final answer. Let's go to the next question. The given question is 8 divided by 88 within the bracket and multiply it by 8888088. Okay, so first you have to do the bracket. So here the 8 divided by 88 is just cancel it out, you will get 1 divided by 11. This is the result in the bracket expression. Then multiply it by 8888088. All you have to do is divide this big number by 11. So let's divide it. 8888 divided by 11. So 8 elevens are 88. The remainder is 0. Put down the 8. You have to put 0 and then again put out the 8. Put 8 elevens are 88, which is 0. Put down 0. So you have to put 0 in here and again put 8 here. So 0 here and 8 here. 8 times 11 is 88. So your final answer is this. 808008. This is your final answer. Let's go to the next question. So here there are two similar problems. Let's take a look at the first problem. Here there are two operations, both are division. So which division should we do first? If you do this division, here also there will be two possibilities. The first one is, if you do the first division and then the second one, so if you divide 100 divided by 20, you will get 5, and then divide it by 5, you will get 1 as the answer, right? But if you do the second division, you will get 100 divided by, what is 20 divided by 5? It's 4. And what is 100 divided by 4? We will get 25. So here also there will be two possibilities. So what is the answer? Is it 1 or 25? So which division should be calculated first? The answer is very simple. Do the left division first. Okay. Starting from the left, you have to do the all the divisions up to right. So the correct answer is 1, not 25. This is the another similar problem. Do the first division first. So 1260 divided by 15 divided by 5, and this is like 420, and divide this number by 5, you will get 84. And then do the second division. 84 divided by 7, you will get 12. So 12 is the right answer. Let's try to solve this one. Okay. So first, let's do it by part. Okay. First, do the numerator and then do the denominator. So see the Bournemouth rule. First, do the bracket. Whatever the expression is in bracket, you have to do this first. Okay. First, do the bracket. So what we got here? 6. Plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 is equal to 24 divided by 6. Okay, and then divided by, let's take the denominator part. You got plus and division. Don't add these 4s because there is a bracket in the numerator. So you add it first and then divide. But there is no bracket in there. So you have to do the division plus and then the addition. So divide this 4 divided by 4, you will get 1. And then put these all 4s in there. 4 plus 4. Are you guys following? Okay, so there is no bracket in there. So you have to do the division first. So I divide 4 divided by 4, which gives 1, and then add those all remaining 4s. Now, what is 24 divided by 6? You get 4. And what is the value of this expression? 4 plus 4 plus 4, 12 plus 1 is 13. So the final answer is 30. 4 by 13 is the final answer. Here is the another problem. The given is 3640 divided by 14 into 16 plus 340. So by the Bournemouth rule, you have to do the division first. So 3640 divided by 14 and then multiply it by 16, add it to 340. Now cancel out this 14 and 16 by 2, you get 7 in here and 8 in here. Now divide 3640 by 7, cancel out, you get 520. Now multiply these two numbers, 520 into It's 4160 and add with 340, you will get 0054. So 4500 is your answer. There are two another operations beyond Bournemouth's rule. They are, one is bar operation and the second one is modulus operation. Everyone knows about the modulation, right? The modulus gives the positive values. For example, if I take modulus for negative 5, you will get 5 as an answer. If you take modulus for the positive 5, it is already positive, so it will give the 5. So modulus, the purpose of modulus is to change the negative value into positive, and if it is positive, then it also gives the positive value. The bar is the line bracket. You know, for example, if there is an expression like this, 3 minus 2 plus 1 bar, the bar is only for 2 plus 1, you have to do the bar first. So the result will be 3 minus 3, which is equal to 0. Let's take an example for these two operations. Let's solve this expression. The given is 25 minus 40 minus 80 under the bar multiplied by modulus of 3 minus 6. First, do the bar. So you get 25 minus, what is 40 minus 80? It's minus 40. Put bracket in there and multiply by, what is 3 minus 6? 3 minus 6 is minus 3 under the modulus sign. Right? The modulus value of negative 3 is positive 3. And the minus times minus is positive, plus 40 plus 25. Now apply the Bournemouth's rule. You have to multiply it first. You get 40 times 3 is 120, and then add it, you get 145 as the answer. Before applying the Bournemouth's rule, if there is any modulus operation or bar operation, you have to do that first. Friends, I really hope that you enjoy this video on simplification and Bournemouth's rule. Here are two problems for you to work out in your home. Let me know the answer in the comment section for these two problems. I hope you like this video. Share this with your friends and comment if there is any suggestions for this video. Subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications. Thank you for watching. This is Success EdTech video by Ganga. Thank you very much, guys.